EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Denver Broncos and the New Orleans Saints. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Let's go.
The 40. A big time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. On second and 11 now. Jackson. And this is Cook with a grab. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose. A three-yard gain and enough for the first down. First down, and it's Pollard again. This will be a five-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and five. From the gun, Jackson on the move to his left. And this one's incomplete. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. And now it's third down. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right, they did something to disrupt that timing.
57, Mike 57.
From the gun on third down, Jackson. And he finds Cook. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now here's Pollard, and he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Tony Pollard, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point good by Prater, and that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken short. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And an alley to run. He'll have a first down past the 40. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. The escapability in evidence there as that one good for 15 and a first. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And going deep for Hill. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll set up a throw. And going deep for Hill. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Eddie Jackson picks it.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
We want it. Come to my world. Where's 52?
Here's Jackson. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Jackson. From the left side, it's complete.
We always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. The completion good for three, and it's second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 45-yard line. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Watch the curl.
And an alley to run. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. That one a gain of 20 and a first down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Saints touchdown. Lamar Jackson his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Prater for the extra point. And it's now 14-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken very short. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that.
Oh, this is intercepted, intended for Hill. Picked off at the 23. And a great return as he takes this up just shy of the 45.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. Some space here, and he is out of bounds inside the 35. An excellent run of 22 yards on the keeper, and also a first down.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon, and that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Jackson from the shotgun. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints' touchdown. In for the score. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. Great corner route there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field, and you break. Boy, that was well executed.
This will be taken short. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And some dangerous territory. Already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any point. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Three scores down, not even a halftime yet. They're not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
Naeem Hines, his first carry. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down. Well executed there on second down, so do you go back to the air on third?
Well, that's a possibility, but now you've opened up things to where you showed that you would run the ball in long-distance situation. You might come back again because I doubt they believe you'll do it a second time.
Eluding the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9. They're going to try and throw. And going deep for Hill. That's caught at the 25. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Tyreek Hill. His fifth touchdown now on the year. As they are now on the board here in the first half. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
Second and goal from the six this time. Now a give, right side. Hines. And he's able to get it down to the two-yard line. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Try to run with Hines. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. Naeem Hines, his fifth touchdown now on the year. As his guys are back within a single score. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They've seen their 21-0 advantage cut to just seven, so time to go back to work here, first and 10. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven, past the 30 to the 32.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it, and while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way. I do know that owners, when they watch their quarterbacks running with the football, they usually hold their breath because that's the franchise. But when you're getting that kind of a game, hard to argue against calling it.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. Nothing fancy there, a little smash-mouth football right up the gut on the dive, and it turns into a huge play.
You talk about the fastest way to the secondary. Right up the gut, as you described, and sprinted into the secondary for a long, long run.
And here he'll get it down to the seven. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
Let's go, D. Big Sears right here. We got to step it up. Check, 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 check. Yeah, yeah.
On second down, it's Pollard. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Still a couple yards short of the first as the three-yard gain brings up a third down.
Watch the run, watch the run. Check 52. Watch the ship, watch the ship. Hey, hey, watch the ship. Check 24, check 24. Watch that, watch that, watch that.
Trying to run for it with Pollard. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. He'll try to run this one in. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. On second down, Pollard, and he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Let's go, let's bring it, let's bring it. Check the backer, check the backer.
57.
It's our field. It's our field. Good. It's our house. He's checking.
On third down, it's Pollard. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the three. Fourth down now after a loss of two. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
And the 13-year man puts it through. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken very short. Able to power through.
We got this.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
In your face.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
Let's go next. Mike 54. Let's put him on the buses. Let's put that.
Now a play fake here on first down. And going deep for Hill. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Tyreek Hill with his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. As they are now just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game. Extra point by Marr, up and good. And that cuts the lead to 3, 24-21. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. And now he'll tuck it and run. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down.
I hope you brought your left, because I'm about to take you to school. 5-2 is the mic. Mike 5-5.
This time Jackson will throw it. Well, the two men come together and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up 4th down.
Partner, the way this offense has marched up and down the field during this game, it's almost a surprise to see an incomplete pass on third down, isn't it?
Yeah, they have had their foot on the gas all game long, but here finally stalling out. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now? Kidding had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Get this to the 40, but that's still going to be a few yards short of the first down. Call it a gain of four, but not enough. The punt team going to need to be summoned here on fourth down. Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the two-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own two-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The one-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So, yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
A little more room here on second and six from the six. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now this time he'll look to throw. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give him credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Here's Hill on the return. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now a give, right side. High. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. This is Hines. And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Big stop, D. Big stop.
Here's second and eight. Flushed out right. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field.
I'm going back to you. Check, 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 check. 22, check, 22,
check. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third down and 12.
Under crush, under crush, under crush. Shit, watch the shit.
Now a give, right side. It's Hines. It's a gain of five, but it'll lead to a fourth down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. So with less than a minute gone by, the field goal there gets this thing back to even.
And it's setting up for a fantastic finish, isn't it, partner? It's been a well-played game, a hard-hitting game. The fans are into it. The announcers are into it. This is going to be a great fourth quarter.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
14 yards is the pickup. First down, New Orleans. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second and nine. Jackson, flush to his right, throwing right, and that's complete. And they'll get to him after a gain of seven to the 47.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
They'll run with Pollard, and he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. Hasn't been his best afternoon on the ground, far from it, but a critical third down conversion.
His afternoon just got better. All right, you're exactly right. It hasn't been his best in terms of yardage, but that run there, that's the one your teammates look to you and go, okay, that's what we want from you, that's what we need. Now they have a chance to keep moving forward and a chance to win the game.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. From midfield now, here's Jackson. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 23 yards the pickup there. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Slam, slam. Rush in, rush in, rush in.
quickly here, and that's complete. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And they're facing a big 3rd down now in this tie ball game.
Check Mike 27. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Bang, 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 bang. Bang, bang.
Now it's Jackson. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This for the lead in the final stages. On the money, it's good, and they have taken the lead here in the final 2 minutes. Big kick right there to give them the lead in the 4th, but there is still time left for a final drive.
Did they score too soon? Post game will tell us, right? Depending on what happens on this drive, that's how we'll analyze it. If the other team scores, they scored too soon. If they somehow hold on, they manage the clock exactly right.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on 3rd and 1. Now a give, right side. It's Hines. And he's got the 1st down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Here's Hines. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now the Broncos going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. Now the Broncos will use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds.